Are you gonna bolt it down?
No. The last one just kind of like sat there. But now I'm looking at it, it's like, where the fuck am I gonna put a amp at?
On the back of the seat?
Up there, maybe? Maybe back up in there?
How big is the amp?
I think the amp is shit.
I would say on the back, probably on the back of the seat.
I don't know how to take that back seat off.
You can't lay it down?
Do it lay down? No, I don't think these lay down. I think these like unbutton. Shit, slit, nigga. We can pop all this shit off. I mean, I ain't driving the truck, so. Quick update, got some new speakers, subwoofers for the truck, and a new box, amp kit, the whole nine for the truck. The only thing we didn't get was the amp. But anyways, long story short, man, took the speakers out the box, tried to slide it in the sub box, and they didn't fit. They were too big. Put in a new order for some new speakers. Meantime, man, went ahead and started taking the truck apart. That way we can go ahead and get some action going, get this thing installed. By the time the speakers get here, amp get here, all the wires and everything ran, all I gotta do is just do a quick connect, call it a day. So I'm gonna let y'all see what we got going so far. Speaker box right here that's kind of sitting at a standstill. Man, boy, it's bright out here, y'all, today. It's a little chilly. So I went ahead and started taking all this stuff apart. I gotta vacuum this car out. I gotta vacuum this truck out. So went ahead and started taking all the kick panels, floor panels apart on both sides. Back and front, both sides. Just to get to this wiring ordeal situation for the speaker wires, we can kind of tap in. What I'm gonna end up doing is doing a line out converter, which I went ahead and swung by Best Buy today and ended up getting that. So went ahead and tried to go, went ahead and expose this, tapped into this one. I gotta tap into the other side, and then I'm gonna go ahead and run these wires for the line in. So I gotta run two on both sides, positive and negative for the speakers. And as soon as my homeboy get over here, we're gonna go ahead and run the power wire from the battery all the way back on the driver's side. So stay tuned to that. All right, peoples, and we back, and we back. Quick update. So I got my homeboy over here. He tapping into the driver's side with the speaker wire. So I've already done this side, so I give you an idea what I did. This is the passenger side right now. So according to GM, you gotta tap in to speaker wires, what was it, 7 and 16 leads. So I did so. I like to keep things color coordinated. You know, I'm so used to red being positive, black being negative. So I did that, tapped in. I can really go ahead and hook this back up and be done with this side. But I'm gonna wait till we get the amp in, make sure we got powder, everything the right way. We gotta take the seats out, so we working. You did, we working. To this man, after we get that side hooked up, like, probably need to just go ahead and take the seats out. This is gonna be a task, but we'll see it, so stay tuned. Say, and we back, and we back. All right, man, so far, man, my homeboy been in good help, like, for real. So we got all the wires connected to the speakers for the line output thingy-majiggy crossover thing. So we're going to hook that up tomorrow. It's freezing out here, y'all. It's cold. But we did go ahead and start tackling getting this power cord connected up underneath. So we tapped into the firewall. I'm gonna pull this through. After that, man, really, man, it's downhill, man. We wait till the equipment come and we connect it. So that's it. So y'all stay tuned to that, man. I appreciate y'all for watching. You know what I mean? So that's it. That thing in there, man. I put my skinny ass hand. This shit hit garbage. Who came up with this?
The next morning.
And we back with another update, and you already know what time it is, man. We got started on this these speakers again, man, and I can't even front with y'all, man. Trying to get that power cord through that firewall. Woo! Luckily I have my homeboy, he came over, you know what I mean? And help me out with that, man. I think my man had a dream about it or something, because my man came up with that master plan and got it through there. So anyways, just as a quick follow, let me show y'all what we got going. So got the power cord fed through. We went ahead and took out the rear seat, and it was fairly easy. It was a total of two screws and four bolts. So one, two, three, four. And then it was two screws connecting the other bracket to the 60-40 split. All right, so anyways, now that we got the cords ran, we got it tapped in here, got all this back in place. I don't know if y'all can see that. Let me see if y'all can see that. Yeah, so we got everything tapped in now. If you can see, right off the side, right near the door. Same thing going in on that end over there, tapped in. Got the cords running alongside. Same situation here. And then right now we're hooking up this this line out converter. Something real cheap, inexpensive, about $14. You know what I mean? And doing it this way, we don't have to tap back in to the radio on the back side. We ain't gotta be taking no dash apart, none of that other stuff. So quick and easy. You dig? And it's simple too, and it got the instructions right down the top to tell you what connect to what. Positive to positive, negative to negative. As long as you do that, man, you can't go wrong. You dig? So right now, man, other than doing that, man, we really ain't got nothing else popping. We're waiting on the amp, waiting on everything to come in, and it'll be plug and go. You dig? So what do you think, T? Then we put amp here.
Yeah.
All right, we're gonna figure out a way to get the amp strapped up here. Problem is, we don't know how big the amp is. So, need enough clearance somewhere. So I think that's gonna be the best spot, either there or in the center. Either way it go, it's going back up here. And that's about it. And this ain't nothing but soft material, so ain't nothing back there. So we can probably drill a hole, use some zip ties that got the push clip connected already to it. And that is it, man. So stay tuned, man, for the update. We're gonna keep this thing going, and y'all probably see everything. Y'all probably see everything connected tomorrow. You did? So stay tuned. And we back with an update. You already know what time it is, man. So we put that work in today, man. I appreciate my homeboy again coming out, man. Hey, man. You know what I mean? It's hard finding friends out here in these streets, you did.
I need to do that again, because it's got that wide thing on me.
Oh, Anastasia got her robe on.
Next to me.
Got a robe on.
Trying to be healthy.
Looking old. Looking old it's with the robe on.
MLK
it's her dog.
Day,
MLK Day, for real. We working on cars and she working in her robe. I don't know what time it is. But anyways, man, so this what we got going on, man. This what we just finished up. Went ahead and got the fuse box ready to go situated. You know what I mean? We're not gonna hook the battery back up, but everything's good on this end. So we gotta trace back. All this I'm gonna zip tie back to this. I'm not sure if I'm gonna do wire loom to make it black because of that blue wire. I might. More than likely I will. That way it'll be cleaner.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So we'll wire loom it, man. Keep it clean. Wire loom it. That's about it, man. On the power side of things, man. And like literally, I was hoping that stuff was gonna come today. I saw a UPS truck fly down the street. I just knew it was mine. I knew it was me. You know what I mean? But it wasn't. So that's dead. But yeah, so all the wiring and stuff ran. I can't wait to get the clip. I'ma zip tie all these, make sure it's nice and neat. You know what I mean? Trust me, it's gonna be clean when I'm done. It's gonna be real clean. Zip tie all this. See, we got it going up under this. I gotta put all the clippings back down. Got the box hooked up, wired up. Everything is good to go. So I'm gonna zip tie all this. I'm just waiting to finish up all the wiring. This is the ground wire. We already figured out what we're gonna ground it at. I'm gonna ground it right off to the side. You know what I mean? Off the side of the chair because they bolt in. So sandwich in between there, man. And then after that, man, we're gonna have sounds, man. Thing gonna be in there, womp, womp, womp. I doubt it. I hope it don't be doing all that rattling. You think it's gonna rattle?
Huh?
You know what I mean? Got neighbors. But we're gonna continue this video, man. You know what I mean? So stay tuned. About 5-10 minutes ago, Amazon pulled up on your boy. And guess what came? The speakers. All right, so now we're gonna do a test fit on these, make sure these actually fit, because as you know, the other ones didn't, and they over there just kind of like cooling. And I'm a little bit nervous about these right now, but we're gonna see what's happening. I'm pretty sure they're gonna fit because I checked out the website, and then the website gave me a recommendation on them, so they should fit. You know what I mean? So we're gonna see what's going on with this real quick. Let's see what's popping. They fit. And we back again. You did, cause that amp came in. You did. Oh, I should be a rapper. Oh, that boy got flow. You feel me? But yeah. So got that amp in, man. Finally. Went ahead and cranked that box open. And to be perfectly honest with y'all, man, to be such a high wattage amp, this is definitely a lot smaller than what I'm used to. Could just be because I've been out of the music game for a minute, the sounds and stuff. Last time I put sounds in a whip, man, I think that was back in the 99 in the 2000, you feel me? No, I had to be like about Nah, like slick. About 99 in the 2000. So they probably making these amps a lot smaller. You know what I mean? For space purposes. So, man, let me see what this thing looking like. Do not mount amplifier to subwoofer box. It's good to know. You dig? Don't mount it to the sub box. Which we already showed y'all what we gonna mount this thing at. So it is what it is. Let's see what this thing look like. See what this thing look like, man. Dang, it's a box in a box in a box. Again. Hey, I commend y'all on these on this boxing score. I commend y'all on that, cause y'all making sure this stuff stays safe. Oh yeah, this thing is definitely nice and compact. Oh, and I'm digging that. I'm digging the size of that. So yeah, that's good. Yeah, that's good. That way I ain't gotta be taking up a whole lot of space with this thing. All right, man. So got it in. We ready to go. You dig? So we gonna get this thing wired up. Look like it's about to rain. So I'm gonna have to catch this on the next day. You feel me? So stay tuned. And we back, you dig? So finally got the speakers and stuff done, y'all. Rain kind of let up, so I went ahead and knocked it out real quick this morning. So, and surprisingly, man, these things knock pretty good. You feel me? So I got it on low right now. So I need to do some cleaning up. This is gonna go up here. It's gonna mount. I already drilled my holes for it. Use these little clip situations, push in clips. So this is it, man. I got it sounding like I want it. Matter of fact, let me go ahead and set this up. Yeah. Got the little John playing. I'm gonna go ahead and turn that down real quick. But yeah, so basically, man, this is just gonna mount up right up in here. All right, let's see how this go. That's gonna sit up there just like that. I don't know if y'all can see that. It's gonna sit up there just like that. So I'm gonna get all these wires and stuff clinked up. You dig? And get that seat back in here a little later. Test this thing out again. And I'm gonna get my gain connected. Yeah. Alright, so I got my power wire in. Everything connected right. My power wire running in right here. I'm gonna get that zip tied up. Connect it to the battery. Yeah, cool. So everything good then. Just gotta get that stuff up on the zip tied. So, yeah. So I'm gonna go ahead and finish this up, man. So let me go ahead and get it cleaned up. Show y'all the aftermath. Gonna wrap this video up, you did. Stay tuned. And we back, you feel me? So, man, finally got that installation done on the speakers. I am stoked about them, pleased with them. I can't even front. The help of my homeboy, you did. You know what I mean? We got them in. You feel me? It took some manhandling on them seats though. So the installation wasn't hard, but it wasn't easy, you dig? So I like it. It sounds really good. Of course, I can't let y'all hear it because it's gonna sound totally distorted over the phone. It's gonna sound distorted over the camera, you dig? But I can give y'all some personal opinions about that. You feel me? What you think about them, T? How you think they sound?
Sound
dope, man. Hey, I hate the area. Well, you dope, feel man. Me?
It sound dope. It sound good. Quality is nice.
You feel me? So, nice. When you hear it, man, that's a third party. I didn't even ask my wife. She sat in the car and she got out immediately. I was gonna say ass, but I think it was hurting her. You know what I mean? Babe, what you think? Oh, it wasn't your type of music? Where you at?
Play that pretty Ricky.
Yes, yeah, she wanna hear the pretty Ricky in that thing. She be in that thing like this. I would not. But yo, man, so that's gonna be the end of this video, man. I'll definitely put some pictures and let y'all see what it turned out. And that's it, man. You did. So stay tuned to the next video. Like I said, make sure you like, comment, subscribe to the channel, man, and follow up. You did. So holla at you.